Hello world and welcome to Microsoft Unboxed. Every week we share stories about Microsoft technology and the people behind that technology. Typically Sonia and I each have a story to share underneath a broader theme, but today we're gonna do things a little bit differently. We're dedicating our entire episode to Code Jumper.
Code Jumper is a set of physical blocks that are specifically designed to teach coding to kids with visual impairment. So it's just one of the many initiatives that Microsoft has been focusing on when it comes to inclusivity and accessibility.
Code Jumper will present opportunities for students around the world to explore careers in computer science.
So we transferred the Code Jumper research and technology to the Louisville, Kentucky-based nonprofit American Printing House for the Blind, or APH. And APH plans to make Code Jumper available in Australia, Canada, India, the UK, and US in 2019, with worldwide distribution by 2024. Because Colleen and I are very jazzed about Code Jumper, we wanted more of an insider's perspective on the project and how it came about. So we actually invited Microsoft senior researcher, Dr. Nicolas Villar, to the studio today. So we're gonna go jump into that little interview with him now. Nick, welcome to the studio.
Thank you, it's so nice to be here.
Nick, what is the origin story behind Code Jumper?
It's actually one of my colleagues, Cecily Morrison, her son was born blind. So she's been very involved in the AA community. She identified early on that there is a difficulty for children that are blind or low vision to learn how to program. The ways that children normally are introduced into programming are very hard for them to adopt. That was really the inspiration.
Who specifically is Code Jumper for?
We designed it for children aged 7 to 11, but really we've seen it work with anyone that is a tactile learner, is interested in learning how to program, and you know, benefits from being able to play and touch. I think I would have loved to learn how to program when I was growing up like that.
I'm very much a tactile learner, so same. I'm looking forward to it. So how did you become interested in this type of research?
I've always been really interested in using technology to enable new forms of interaction, new forms of play. I was super excited straight away that we could build something really special.
Some of your research is really focused on this concept of play.
I think play is so important, you know? It's a human thing to want to play. We learn a lot through play. We communicate through it. So I just feel like that element of fun, there's always a place for it, yeah.
Do you think that you could focus on gamification of my email inbox next?
I'm not sure. Okay.
So how has the project evolved over this time?
It looks completely different from what you saw, you might have seen four years ago. And what we built is completely different. We were very closely with this group of kids that we called the Torino Young Inventor team. As we would come up with ideas, we would test them out. We weren't even really using technology. It was bits of clay and string and rope, whatever we could use to prove out ideas and let them play with it, try things out, and we would observe and, you know, like Wizard of Oz, pretend that things are working. The kids were as much part of the invention process as we were and the design process, and it's completely unexpected to me how I ended up.
I remember reading that one version of Project Torino was blocks, and because there was no differentiation in the blocks tactically, that they were just stacking them up.
Code is sometimes represented as blocks on the screen when you're trying to learn. And we tried to make a physical version of that. The blocks just weren't particularly nice objects to manipulate. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you would drop your program and this thing would just...
Oh.
Your code would literally be scattered all over the floor. So that's what led us to really think about how we wanted to represent the connection between things and down to all the details about exactly what type of connectors we should use that were easy to connect together and disconnect, but also maintain structure, even if you dropped it or you passed your program to someone else across
right.
the table.
What do we have to gain by enabling more people to learn how to code?
This concept of computational thinking and about how you tackle problems, it gives you really useful tools. What we wanted to achieve was just to broaden the base of people that can learn that way of thinking. And by addressing people that might have particular needs, I think we ended up with something that is really easy to use, a pleasure to learn for everyone.
You've created a form of self-expression.
that's a very nice way of putting it, yeah.
Thank you so much for the work that you're doing.
Thank you so much for inviting me to talk about it.
Very exciting.
Thanks.
So now we're gonna split off and go work on our own Code Jumper projects.
Mine's totally gonna be better than Colleen's.
Oh, bring it. So Nick was a great instructor and he taught me a little bit about the kit here. So this is the hub. There are four different inputs to the hub here. I had heard that you could make animal noises or there are different instruments that you can tap into. But I was really fascinated by this potential to create a poem.
Sample sounds, percussion. Ooh, Beethoven's Fifth. I'll do something I can get a little bit more familiar with. Let's do Row, Row, Row Your Boat, DJ version.
So each one of these pods is like a statement in your code. It's a single line of code. And I'll plug in this first pod. It has a sound knob and a duration knob on it. Then I'm plugging that into the third input here. I can see on this PC as well that it has registered my input. Nick told me that that was so they could support the teachers who were teaching many different students how to use this. They could quickly see what was going on.
All right, I'm going to...
Barely.
We're a little earlier.
Row.
Okay, we want row. How fast?
Row.
Oh, molasses. Okay. We do chipmunks version.
This is a British poem about Dr. Foster who went to Gloucester.
Dr. Foster went to Gloucester.
Isn't that so cute?
Row.
Okay, saying row once, but I need it to do row, row, row. So I need to loop it because I don't have enough blocks to add three rows. Handy dandy yellow one is the loop. I need to figure out how many times I'm rowing.
Three.
Row, row, row your boat. Okay. I need to close the loop.
Your boat.
Ah, no. Okay, let's try it.
Row, row, row.
Music to my ears.
Dr. Foster went to Gloucester.
In a shower of rain.
Okay, so we have some adjustments to make on the speed
Dr.
of sound.
Foster, my life is but a dream.
It sings so high. This is the octaves.
Your row,
row, row, row your boat.
Life is but a dream.
Where am I missing? I wish I had this kid's pipes. He can sing. Merrily, 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 merrily. Four Merrilies. He's very merry. He was not very merry in that one.
There we go.
Went to Gloucester.
Great, and then this third one.
He stepped in a puddle.
Yes, okay, we're doing great now. I'm finding the bugs in my code here.
This has it go, how many? I just want to hear that. You could hear, like, dogs could hear that if you want. And this is gonna go in the yellow, in the blue.
And now went there again.
Okay, let's speed that up.
And never went there again.
All right, I think we're ready.
Dr. Foster went to Gloucester in a shower of rain. He stepped in a puddle right up to his middle and never went there again.
Ha ha! My first Project Torino code.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream.
Question.
Merrily, merrily, life is but a dream.
Oh, I forgot a merrily.
Merrily, 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 life is but a dream.
Ah! And then I can do the remix and I could add in like the other threads and we could have row, row, row. Like you've seen Hocus Pocus, right? When they're all sitting in the cages at the end. And I think mine's gonna be way better than Kubrick.
That was a blast.
Yeah. This is my first time really like pulling together a coding project. I've never done it. I know! I learned what it was like to use looping. It was really interesting. I even just thought the physical design, very kid friendly. Sonia friendly.
Good for you.
Yeah, what'd you do?
I thought that I wanted to do something musical as well.
DJ Brian.
I don't really have the vocabulary of music at my command. I opted instead for a poem, and it was a great introduction to me to this concept of bugs and troubleshooting bugs. At Microsoft, this focus on accessibility is like very much woven into our ethos as a company. So I have really high hopes about the potential of this technology to empower a new generation of coders.
And I love how they're inspiring blind and low vision children, you know, that they can code and they can do this. And that was really heartwarming.
Speaking of empowering everyone to achieve more.
That's a transition.
I'm going to let you achieve an answer to this question. We're in the outside the box segment now. Hello, everyone. What is your favorite season? And why?
The reason why anyone stays in Seattle is because of the summer. I'd say summer is by far my favorite season. At first I thought you were gonna ask, like, what is your ideal date? It's like April 13th.
Oh yeah.
It's not too hot, it's not too cold. You just need a light sweater.
A light jacket.
A light jacket.
I think that's the line. You can ask me a question now.
Oh, thank you for the permission. Colleen, are you an early bird or a night owl?
I am 100% an early bird.
Yeah, you are.
I love like being in the world before everyone else's. I love getting up bright and early, a nice meditation, warm coffee, great breakfast before everyone is up and getting in my space.
It's usually my inbox is full of like Colleen O'Brien before like 7:05. And I'm like, okay, she is up and at 'em today.
If you have any questions that you'd like to ask us, please be sure to email them to the address below or comment.
And please remember to subscribe to our channel if you haven't done so already. We have a new episode dropping every Thursday at 9 a.m. Pacific. Do you want to go build some more Code Jumper projects?
Yeah, absolutely.
I want to try another song. Like, we could totally DJ out of it.
I'm gonna do a joke this time. Yeah, let's go. Let's go. Hey everyone, if you can't get enough of us, I would highly recommend subscribing to our podcast, Women in Business and Technology, available right here.
And you can follow us on Twitter and Instagram at our social handles right here.